Hola mundo, yo me llamo Señor Vélez y en este video vamos a practicar los pronombres. So, this video we're just going to practice some direct, indirect, and double object pronouns. This is a homework assignment that I gave my students, and I thought that in case some of them wanted me to walk them through how to do this, the answers, maybe they've been absent or something, then this might help them out a little bit. So if you want to stick around for practicing direct, indirect, and or double object pronouns, then by all means do so. This is not an instructional video for the most part, but I will be walking you through the process, so I might help you out a little bit there. So for this first these first five sentences right here, what I'm going to want you to do is to rewrite them with a direct object pronoun, and if there's an indirect object pronoun like this one, and this one, change those indirect object nouns to pronouns and rewrite the sentences. For the second activity that's down here, what I'm going to want you to do is pretty much the exact same thing. These ones have both a direct and an indirect object in them, so rewrite the sentences like the model to have a direct object pronoun, which in this one was la, and an indirect, which in this one was me. And down here we're working also with verbs like gustar, so see if you can answer those questions using these verbs that are like gustar. If you want to do this by hand, this document that you're looking at right now is available to you in the description of the video, and you could, if you want to, open it up and print it off and handwrite out your answers if you prefer. Otherwise, I am going to start giving you my answers pretty much right now, so if you want to do this first, do it, and then start listening to my answers, because here we go. So for number one, my friends prepared the dinner, and then it says for you in the parentheses there. So I'm going to say, my friends prepared it for you. So we'll have mis amigos. Now, you is going to change to te, and then the dinner will change to la. We're going to put the people before things, so put the te before the la, and I'll have te la prepararon. We have the students did the homework assignments. This one just has a direct object noun that'll change to a pronoun, so this one's a little bit easier. Los estudiantes las hicieron will be my new sentence. This sentence also just has a direct object noun to change to a pronoun, so it'll be mi madre lo escuchó. My mom listened to it, basically. This one we have you sent the letter to me, so a mí will change to me, the letter will change to la, so your new sentence is going to be tú me la mandaste. And then the next one down here, we have John wrote the note to her. Now, to her is going to change to le. The note will change to la. So I have le and la, but as you've learned, you can't have the two L pronouns together. So I'm going to change the first, the indirect le to se. So a new sentence is going to be John se la escribió. Let's go down to part two here. Pretty much the same type of a thing here. So I prepared the sausages for her, so she's going to change to lay. The sausages will change to lost, so I've lay and lost. Can't have two L's together, so the first one will change to say. So my new sentence is going to be yo se las preparé. The next one here, we have the waiter served the pasta to us. We will change to no, so the pasta will be lost. So my new sentence is going to be el mesero nos la sirvió. Let's see, number three down here, we have the Tasmanian devil brought the carrots to Bugs Bunny. Bugs Bunny will change to lay. The carrots will change to loss. So we'll say we have lay and loss. We can't have lay and loss together, so it's going to be El Diablo de Tasmania se las trajo, for he brought them to him. Let's see, in this one, I will change to me. The taco will change to lo. So we'll have mi amigo me lo recomienda. So let's down here in part three, we have verbs that work like gustar. So this first question, ¿qué te interesa? What interests you? This is a really broad question, so I'm going to answer it in three different ways to kind of give you an idea of how you could answer this question. So let's say that there is an activity that I like to do. So we're going to talk about a verb here. So maybe I'm interested in reading. Me interesa leer. Now let's say there's a noun that I want to say I'm interested in, like maybe the video game. So now let's look at this next sentence. Maybe there are multiple things, nouns, that I'm interested in. Like maybe I'm interested in these books over here. So notice the difference here with interesar, here to here. See how it goes to plural? Because the books are plural. So the interesar goes with what comes after it. It's either going to be the singular form, like interesa, or the plural form, interesan. This next question is quite similar, so I'm going to just answer it one way. What fascinates you, basically, is the question. So, me fascinan los deportes. I'm fascinated by sports. Number three is, do you love or do onions bother you, basically? So, I like onions in my food sometimes, so we will say, me encantan las cebollas. And if you don't like them or they bother you could say me molestan las cebollas. You'll notice all these questions are asking you, so you're always going to answer with me. If you're talking about a him or a her, this right here would be le. If it was us that we are that are bothered by the onions, it'd be nos. And if it's them or ustedes, it's going to be les. Down here we got is your education important to you? So hopefully you're going to say si. Me importa mi educación. And lastly, are you interested by or do soap operas bother you? I don't really like them. They're kind of boring. So we'll say me molestan las telenovelas. So again, this was just a homework assignment for my Spanish students, Spanish 2 students. If you have any questions about it that I can answer for you, just leave a comment in the comment box and I'll get back to you pretty quick. Otherwise, thanks for watching and enjoy the rest of your day.